the blood, oh, the precious blood of the Lamb.
But you can't have it. I'm gonna jump directly into my application. Just jump into the application. I'm telling you that Jonah is much like us. While he is a prophet, called prophet in the 8th century BC to the northern tribe of Israel, he still is just like us. The focus of the message hinges on his call. His call. His divine calling. The purpose that he's supposed to serve. His solemn appointment with God.
Yeah, yeah.
That which he is supposed to be doing. That which he should be committed to. That which he should be dedicated to. The reason that God put him here in the first place. His call. The application is that all of us, every one of us, every single solitary one of us has a call. Because when God puts you here, when God opened the door for you to be in this world, he also gave you a call. And every one of us has a call. Now, it may be the case that you don't know what your call is. But we all have a call. Amen, right here. We all have a divine appointment with God. Now, we can choose to do one of two things. We can ignore the call. We can act like, we can pretend like we don't have a divine call. We don't have a divine appointment. And we can live our lives on our own terms. Y'all know what I mean? That's when you decide to do what you want to do. You're going to live life your way. You're going to do what you want to do because you're big enough to do it. And whatever your heart's desire is, that's exactly what you're going to do. That's one thing. You can just choose to live life how you want to live life. Because it's your life after all. And you're big enough, you're bad enough to do what you want to do. And you can ignore your call. It may be the case that, secondly, you don't know what your call is. And you kind of been waiting on God to reveal that to you. You kind of been in limbo. You kind of been stagnant in life. You kind of been at a standstill in life. You don't know exactly what you're called. You just waiting on something, somebody to tell you what your call is. And that's why you're not doing what God wants you to do. You're not fulfilling the purpose that God has for you. Maybe that's it. Thirdly and lastly, you can run. Uh-huh. You know. You know exactly what your call is. You know with certainty why God put you here. You know exactly because God has revealed it to you. He has revealed to you exactly what you should be doing. But you decide because your flesh has wrestled with your spirit to get you to do what your spirit knows you should do. Because the flesh is always fighting against the spirit. Y'all come on now. Because the flesh don't want to allow you to be all that God called you to be. And maybe you can't appreciate your assignment. You just don't like what God called you to do. And maybe you're doing something and God's called you to deal with that. Can't be no preacher, can't be no teacher and do what I want to do. Because then people gonna look at me sideways. See, if I wanna hang out, if I wanna do this, if I wanna gratify my flesh, my calling now tells me that I need to be holy. I gotta walk right, I gotta talk right. I got to treat everybody right. I can't go to some places that I want to go. Anybody in here this morning? I can't go to some of the places. I can't do some of the things that I just like to do. Because my flesh is driving my life. But yet, there is God's call on my life. And I've been fighting against my call. And I can run away from my call. I just came by here today to tell you plain and simply that you can run, but you can't hide.